Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back to Enderal. Okay, so I've had some serious problems trying to get the game to work. Essentially, you may notice, and I don't know how you could have not noticed this by now, because I've mentioned it a few times, there are certain sound effects that don't seem to be working. For example, listen. No sound for the bow at all, not drawing the thing back, not firing the arrow, nothing. Also, some of the weapons, like this for example, now has sound effect. What? It wasn't doing it! See, now it stopped again! Okay, I don't understand! But anyway, so I was like, okay, I guess maybe I'm obviously missing some of the audio files. So, first thing I did, I went to my regular Skyrim install, did the verify the integrity of the cache thing, blah blah blah. I was like, okay, 24 files missing, re-downloading them. Pretty sure I re-downloaded the whole of Skyrim, which took forever. Waited for that to happen, launched Enderal, there was an update for Enderal, updated it. Then when I tried to load into the game, it kept spawning me in Riverwood, in the Sleeping Giant Inn. Yes, Riverwood, which shouldn't exist. Also, my dude was naked. Everything was broken. It was like a mix of regular Skyrim and Enderal. It was a monstrosity. So I tried to delete the files without uninstalling everything and keeping like some of it left over and then reinstalling Enderal. Did that. Still kept spawning me in Riverwood with nothing. So I had to completely wipe out everything I had besides my save data, luckily, and then reinstall it again. I did. Here we are. Seems to be working now. However, as you can see, the sound effects are still buggered on certain things. I have no idea why. None. So I guess what I'm gonna have to do before the next episode is once again completely delete everything, make a backup of my save, and then try and re-download it? Like, find like a different download mirror thingy for it or something? Look, I have no idea. But either way, for now, the important stuff seems to be working, like the voice lines and what have you, so we'll go with that. Anyway, last time we did a bunch of things. Essentially, we made it from here-ish to here. Not very far, right? But it took an entire freaking hour. We're trying to get over there to find the strong box which Yero threw into the sea near his house. Then we're gonna head over there to go speak to Alfred, aka Bruce Wayne's goddamn butler, to try and get a cure for our arcane poisoning. Arcane something or other. What's it called? Arcane. I forget the other word, but you know what I mean. Anyway, we found a book in this abandoned, broken ass house, The Butcher of Ark. So I'm just going to read this description here in the journal because it was an insanely long book. Apparently, the quest is to read all of the volumes. Holy crap. I found the volume of the so-called Butcher of Ark on my travels. It seems to be the autobiography of the serial killer Yale Tennyson. I should keep my eyes open for other volumes. Alright, sure. But for now, we're going to head that way. So let's get the hell out of here. My God. So yeah, like I said, what the bloody hell am I stuck on? So like I said, I have no idea. I hear wolves. I have no idea why some of the sound effects seem to be broken. I don't get it. I don't get it. What the hell are you doing? Besides dying, little buddy, there you go. All right, where's your friend? Wait, what? What the hell? Skyrim, why are you so buggy? I don't understand. Like, what happened to my fireballs in my hands just then? I don't think I've installed it wrong. Things seem to be breaking. I don't get it. What was that? What? Interact with the wishing well. Strange noise emanates from the bottom of the well, crystal clear and magical. This is no ordinary well, I think it said. Look down the shaft. Find all wishing wells and return their lost hearts to them. 0-4. Return its heart to the wishing well in the sun coast. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, so let's look down the shaft. Not the first time I've looked down a shaft.
A golden chalice, a grass-colored stone. Bring me back this, so I shan't be alone. Bring my heart back to me.
What do I get out of it? Let's walk away, because we don't have its heart. Can I look down the... Can I... Low creepy. Alright, let's get... Oh, there's like 1,000 wigwams over there, another settlement of some kind, and some kind of, like a farmhouse or something? I trust nothing, man. Everyone we've ran into, you know, since the very beginning anyway, has attacked us. They've like all been bandits. Is this fox gonna attack me? Are you friendly? Urgh. Just make a shot. Urgh. Nope. There will be no witnesses. See, I don't want to have to do that, but, see what it means? Like three fucking highway anyone. What the hell, man? This is not kosher. This is not okay. Sir, I'm not okay with this. Oh, good lord. I have, like, no bloody stamina as well. Alright, hold up, hold up. Do we have a potion we can use? What is the arcane thing called? Do we have a potion we can use? Yeah, here we go. Stamina potion. Okay, so the arcane poisoning whatever. Fever! There you go, arcane fever. The arcane fever only seems to work with healing potions, which, I mean, that's good.
That's all you've got.
That's all you got, Gavner. That's all you got, Gavner. Go blind me, Gavner. Burn! Teabag of justice. Alright, so there's one more over there. Don't know if that's like an animal or something. I will take your helmet and your... I can't take basically anything else. We do have those ice claws we can use for more carry weight. Might be a good idea to take them now. Yeah, I suppose we should. See, it wouldn't surprise me if we use them and then we find out, oh, these are really valuable ingredients for something else. What does it increase it by? 385 out of 368. Is it still 368? 369. What? Motherfucker! Alright. Well, I mean, it's... Wait, 385? Oh, that's right, we picked up a chest plate. Good God, that's bloody heavy. God damn it. God damn it. Alright, what is this worth? Is it worth it for the... Yeah, not really. We'll just get rid of it for now. Alright. Oh, yeah, it totally is another one. You want an archery fight, buddy? I'll give you an archery fight. This would be why I didn't realize he was there, because, you know, the bugged sound effects on the bow. Like the bite of a flea. It's so unsatisfying shooting the bow with no sound. Oh my god! Donk. It didn't make the donk sound. Dude, look at that! Look at the way he died! That's awesome! Alright, hang on. So we can get up to have a look at him. Look! We slumped him over the chair. He looks like he's just casually resting. Alright, give me your money. I'll take your lockpick, and I'll take the arrows back. They don't weigh anything, right? I hope not. Okay, seems to be a book down there. Bandit camp discovered. Okay. What's in the box? Potion of fire rancid, sure. Sets lost ones up to level 12 on fire and makes them flee for 30 seconds. That's like turn undead or something like that. So yeah, camp seems pretty worth picking up because it's like half the value of the chest plate and £1 instead of 20. So sure, we'll take it. We'll take it. I remember I did that in the beginning of my Oblivion playthrough, but it was actually the majority of it. Well, it was a good while anyway that I was stealing a lot of silverware for money. The Disciplines of Magic Entropy. I feel like we might have already found this book. No, I don't think we did. I don't remember that skull. I probably should read this, shouldn't I? Alright, screw it. Along with psionics, entropy is one of the most infamous of the magical disciplines and is part of the school of Sinistra. It is comprised of the manipulation of life and death, the conjuration of supernatural creatures, and the use of necromancy. An entropic mage brings about eventualities which alter a being's life force, thus he does not hesitate to revive deceased beings, imbuing them with artificial life and so deliberately turning them into lost ones. Undead marionettes obeying his will. Furthermore, entropists understand how to conjure magical anomalies, ethereal creatures such as wolves, bears, or trolls, and elemental... Oh, that's right, we can summon a wolf that we haven't used yet. And elementals or weapons. However, the most abominable and dangerous form of entropy is necromancy. In this discipline, the conjurer is able to focus the energy of death and use it against his enemies. To understand this, the student of magic must be aware of the following. Death is an omnipresent power inherent in every living being. It is present from the day of one's birth. Although for the first 2 decades, one's life force can withstand it. Afterwards, however, it drains one's vitality little by little until it is spent. An entropician is capable of bringing death that exists in other realities into ours in a focused way. The result is a fearsome thunderstorm of lightning and fire, the sounds of which resemble the cries of the fallen ones. Indeed, necromancy exceeds all other schools in terms of sheer destructiveness, but at the same time, the practice draws upon the mage's life force as well. It is not uncommon for entropists themselves to die through the excessive use of their magic. 2. Reputation. The use of entropy is forbidden to Path, I think this is. Abiding Arcanists and is punishable as a capital offense. The bone... Okay, so it's necromancy. It's forbidden, just like in regular Skyrizzle. The bone readers of the Skyrag and rumor has it some mercenaries from Melee are known for practicing it. While the motivation of the latter remains unknown, the Skarrag consider entropy to be holy, which is no wonder, considering their general barbarism and pathlessness. Nevertheless, for reasons unknown, the Bone Readers seem to be more successful in bearing the physical consequences of its use. Key elements of the Skarragian entropy include bones and body parts of the deceased, as well as diverse narcotics by which the Bone Readers believe they are able to establish contact with the dead. It is assumed that they believe the bones function as some sort of focusing point. Of course, if these barbarians had any proper knowledge about magic, such ostentation would be absolutely unnecessary. Interesting. So yeah, necromancers. And it sounds like voodoo to a degree. Who do you do? That's a small snippet of a song from Labyrinth with David Bowie. R.I.P. You were fucking awesome. All right, we'll take all this. We'll take all of this crap. What's in here? Ooh, blueprints. Magic imbued robe. Ooh, I want that. I want that. Oh my god. Flamer of Flames. And a light book of... My god. All right, we're racking up the goodies here. We ain't gonna be able to carry that without being over encumbered. It'd be very handy if we can rest in this bed. What can we drop now? Could drop my ball and hat. It does weigh an awful lot, doesn't it, really, considering it's a bit shit. Alright, we'll drop the ball and hat. Why am I not wearing better gloves? Yeah, these have, like, no armor. Let's get rid of those. We'll put on the chain gloves and the chain boots. Actually, no, we have these. Yeah, the sunstep boots on. We'll leave those. Vagrant dress. Decent value for the weight, kind of. We'll drop one of those for now. Alright, can I rest here? Yes, I can. Whoop! Since it might be worth sleeping around until it's light again, so we don't have to travel during the night so much. Let's explore the rest of the town first, and then we'll do that. I probably should also test out this claymore. Can't use my magic if I'm doing that, but... I mean, it might have sound effects. That's more what I'm concerned about. Oh my god. Nope. What the hell, man? I don't understand. Like, what the hell? Like I say, I'll try and reinstall it completely with a different download before the next episode, but I really don't know what I could have done wrong, to be honest with you. Like, it's pretty straightforward. You know, you download it, you click install. Wasn't really much else. And again, we've got, like, all the voice lines and, you know, everything seems to be fine. It's just a few, like, weapons. Holy crap! Okay, then. It's like a few weapon sound effects. Okay, so that was a trap to get us when we were going in as opposed to out. I mean, you know, nice try. Right. Oh, yeah, okay. I was wondering around for a reason because I knew there was something I was forgetting. It was the spell tome for the wolf. Here we go. Summon ghostly wolf. Sure. Do we have any other spell tomes that we can use? Doesn't look like it. All right, so let's bring up a magic menu. So it's Entropy Novice, 39 cost, bloody hell. Do we even have enough magic for that? Yes, apparently so. What up? Look at it, it's adorable. Hey, buddy. Look at his eyes. Who's in the dwarf? Yes, you are. I want a dog. I don't have a dog, it sucks. Alright, let's get out of here. Whoa. Sure, pull out our weapon. Which, again, now has sound effects. That will probably just suddenly stop. No idea. No idea. So confused. Alright, so it seems there's some kind of stables over there. We could maybe buy or rent a horse. I have no idea. Let's try checking this out since we're right next to it. We are closing in, it would seem. Yeah, pretty damn close to where that strongbox is. Good. We have bloody time. Oh, that's right. I was going to rest to make it daytime. Well, hopefully we can do that here. Oh, this is Yero's house. Ah, let's save, because it wouldn't surprise me if there are dudes in here. There's blood. Blood! Why is this door locked? There you go. Hello! Whatever we're looking for is probably... Actually, it could be this. Yeah, it could be that. There's also a staff here. Staff of healing. Sure. Overencumbered, I know. Alright. I'll do it. I'll drop the damn robes. Just relax. It's gonna be fine. There you go. Alright. Worth getting out my torch. A lot of cheese. So it's spoiled for some reason. Well, I mean, I guess it's probably been here a long time. Now, so far, they seem to have hidden a lot of stuff in places like this, so I'm gonna try and be thorough. Why are you floating? What the hell? I can't even interact with it. Okay, that's a little strange. Here you go. Footprints of the well-traveled one and it's a set item. Worth a lot. Doesn't weigh much. Good, good, good. Horseshoe is a tool, apparently. Okay. Good to know, I guess. What was that? Take a turner ears? Oh, okay, so it's, wasn't this called, like, Elfies or Elf something or other in Skyrim? Alright, so let's open up this. By the way, I only had, like, 2 hours sleep. I should be asleep now, so if I am not quite my usual chipper self, that's why. I'm freaking exhausted, man. I was supposed to record this, like, over an hour ago. But, you know, it was derping out. Increase your stamina by 10 points. What ring are we using, and can we use more than one ring in this game? I doubt it. No, just the one ring. And I'd say this is better, because we're not using a shield right now. Oh, we're leveled up! Yeah! Sure, let's get more HP for now. We'll try and spread it somewhat evenly between HP and magic, and then maybe if I feel like we need stamina, we'll go with that. But, I mean, our stamina is a bit shit, but it's not really a huge deal compared to the other two, I would say. Alright, where's my torch? There you go. Okay. Six. Yep, I knew there had to be dudes in here. Had to be dudes in here. Well, not literally dudes, but they're alive. What's this sort? Sure, we'll take it. Pit rat. And, okay, so nothing on you either. Anything hidden behind the table? Nope. Open up your hero menu. That's right, we probably should, is this the same book? It's worth quite a bit, so we should probably just pick it up to sell it. Yeah, same book. Yeah, we can teleport back to that place to use our skill points, essentially, so we should have two now, I would think. Yeah, memory points. Not skill points. Memory points. Oh, two more blueprints. Oh, we already have the small backpack one, okay. So there's not just one of each blueprint. I would imagine you can probably buy more blueprints from, like, vendors and towns and things. It might have even said that on a load screen. Hey, the chest ain't backwards. Can I carry all of that? No. I'll leave the candlestick then. And that overcome me as well? Oh my god, what did I just pick up? Plane. Also a tool. Plate, which is clutter. These are clutter, they're really not worth that much, I suppose. Oh god, the yeah. What? Really? That wasn't enough. Oh, the candlestick's worth taking. Alright, give me a second here to make some space. Let's drop. Yeah, we'll drop. Actually, yeah, we'll keep one hatchet, because you can probably woodcut again, like you can in Skyrim. Generally speaking, they don't seem to have taken stuff like that out, they've just used it differently. I thought that was, like, an enemy over there, but no, it was a flag. Hmm. There definitely wasn't a bed that we can use in here, was there? Oh, hello. So there's a cellar. Need a key. It could be in that strongbox that he threw over the edge. That would be my guess. It makes sense. I really probably should go back to that camp to use the bed over there. I apologize if you can see the frame rate dipping. It runs like shit, to be honest with you. Actually, yeah, they may have even turned the graphics back up since I reinstalled it. So, you know, if you see some dips, just, why is there a ghost here? What? Oh, I can't interact with it. Is this a clue or something? Hmm. I don't know what they want from me there. But yeah, if you see some dips, I apologize. I'll try and get it to run a little bit better before the next episode. But yeah, honestly, it just doesn't run very well compared to regular Skyrim. I would imagine it's because they probably have a bunch of scripting things going on. But you don't really know. So, Bennett Camp is just to my left. I could probably just look at the compass, but, you know, I'm an idiot. Alright, so here we go. Let's rest until it's 7 p.m. Let's go until, like, I don't know, sure, thereabouts. Oh, and it does the slow, oh god. Oh god, I miss Morrowind where it was just instant. 4, 5, 6. Okay, so almost 7 a.m. just about getting light, which means we can get rid of the torch. Beautiful. Beautiful. Alright. Again, I want to check over there, because there seems to be a house, but, you know, one thing at a time, let's try and go get the strongbox, or whatever we're looking for. I think it is a strongbox. Man, there's some, like, really freaking loud waterfalls in, well, everywhere in this game. Look, it's a bird. If I had a fireball, I'd shoot you down. Dude, this looks awesome, man. Like, you gotta remember as well, they've designed all of the landscape here. Like, just take a moment to appreciate this. At 30 FPS. It's so freaking good, man. Okay, I'm gonna be fine. There we go. I'm gonna save you. I see a bunch of skeletons over there. Actually, are they alive? I can't tell if they're alive. They're not, right? No, they're not. Pretty freaking solid as well. There is a big-ass crab, though. It's an imposing king crab. You're imposing, sir. You're imposing on my property. Get the hell out of here! Let's use... Hang on a minute. Where the hell did I put the lightning? Oh, it's on 2. Good work, brain. See, my logic is... kind of like Pokemon, it's a water type, so it's gonna be weak to electricity, right? I mean, it worked. He's dead. Crab shell. Alright, I think we're alone now. So what the hell do you have here? How much space do we have? Jack shit. I need to find a town, because, I mean, obviously I'm carrying a lot of crap. I'm well aware of that, but the intention is to sell it. It's got an itty-bitty chest. It's adorable, look at him. He's contemplating. He's contemplating life. Wait a minute. That's weird, man. It's like they're having just like a casual chat, but they've died whilst having a casual chat. And their bones have stayed perfectly still. Skeletons, man. Holy shit. That's a big-ass crab, ain't it? Is it alive? I think it's dead. Dude, that was terrifying. I thought we were about to get mauled. Okay. So, are you just like scenery, or do you do anything? That's very cool. There's another one over there. I see you, you son of a bitch. You're not an opposing king crab, you're just a river crab. And you're too damn heavy to pick up. Wait a minute. There's a bit of castle up there. That's really cool. Alright, like I said, let's grab the strong box. We're right next to it. Yes, there you are. Alright, and we get his diary. The diary might tell us where the key is, maybe? Tell Jespar about Yero's life letters. I guess we need to read this, don't we, really? Yero's diary would be... where the hell... here we go. Alright, let's read this. Hopefully I don't trip over my words too much, but I really struggle to read this font, so just expect it. First letter, my name is Yero Sunwind, and this is my first life letter. Last night, Syrah and I had a lengthy talk about our plans for the future. At one point, Syrah noticed that a lot of visionaries tend to become cynical, the reason being they lose sight of their goals. These documentations shall record my aspirations. In moments of weakness, I want to read these to remind myself of what is dear to me. Well, this is the first one. Just yesterday, the Keeper of the Order from Ark visited the village. If that weren't enough, he also detected some magic inside me. Is that even possible? Me, an Arcanist? It's difficult to express my feelings with words. I feel like all my hard work is finally paying off. Interestingly, this arouses a peculiar, somewhat morbid thought. Maybe it is in some sad way even good that my mother passed away. That's fucked up, buddy. Why? Because it opened my eyes. Now I don't feel anything other than a lack of understanding and yes, even anger towards the simpletons of the village, both the children and adults, day after day. It is always the same. They get up, walk, and let themselves be amused by the bards in the evening. Can't they see what's happening with the world? Everything they pass on, should it really be just a brief inscription on a stone? Syrah is different. She understands me, she shares my dream, and if Master... Igraz accepts me accepts her as an apprentice, we could continue to be as close in the novitiate as we are right now. Noviciates? Don't know. Second letter. 15 years have passed, and a lot of my wishes have come true. Does he mean since the first letter? Sira and I are now living together, but with the craftsman, instead of in the temple quarters. It has been 5 years since I completed the holy trial. Despite what I had originally planned, I have decided against the military path and will be a school teacher instead. Why? Because I believe that I can teach a lot more people by sharing my vision with the young rather than fighting in wars. Such things might sometimes be necessary, but they stand for everything that I stand against. Beyond that, the Truchessa has recently adopted the food bank bill, which Sira and I developed together. Twice a year, rich Enderalians are obliged to contribute a handful of pennies into a chest with which the poorest in the Undercity are brought a warm meal. The reactions were mixed. Some agreed almost enthusiastically, while others were outraged. Often I would hear things like, "It's their own fault they live in misfortune," or, "If they would actually work, they wouldn't starve." Genius. Such people make me fucking furious. What cursed ignorant fools is this? I kind of made that part up, but we'll go with that. Of course, it's easy for them to see the sky from the top of their ivory towers, but they will never understand the plight of the poor. Despite how angry this letter might seem, I'm quite content overall. I'm starting to feel as if I have a purpose, that I'm moving in the right direction, and my happiness is due in no small part to the woman who has always stayed by my side throughout all of these years. It's strange. I know you will probably never read these pages, just as I might never see one of your letters, but still, I have a feeling as if I'm writing these words that I'm talking to you through the ink. With that in mind, I love you, Sarah, baby. Third letter. Sarah is dead. Fuck. Killed by a group of scoundrels as she was delivering food for the food bank in the Undercity. How quickly these words have been written down, but how can I express this anguish, this emptiness? Even remotely, it sounds so absurd. I'm talking to a piece of paper because no one else wants to listen to me. Nor could they even remotely understand what this means to me. Sarah always told me that these letters would give me strength, but they don't. These lines appear unfamiliar to me. Everything feels wrong. I feel wrong as I get up in the morning. I feel wrong when the sun hides behind the clouds. Cloudy sky at noon. And I feel wrong as I lie alone in this big bed in the evening. This is depressing as fuck. Malthus judges suicide to be a sin. What? Oh, Malthus judges suicide to be a sin. Since every one of us has a purpose in life to fulfill, but could this really be my purpose? I might have 30 winners left at most, depending on whether or not an illness snatches me away, and behind me I can see nothing but foul dreams. Our damned food bank has led to downright wars at the banquets of the Undercity, the rich trying to weasel their way out of making payments as much as they can. And in front of me, I can see nothing but fog. That seems most fitting. So tell me, Malthus, is this really my path? Is this my purpose, to be a failure whose fate it is to die alone? My thoughts are chaotic, and I'm tired. I don't want to keep writing. Holy shit. That's some depressing stuff. Let's think about entertaining things like, puppies. Puppies are pretty awesome. You can either take that as, you know, slang for boobs or just actual puppies. Both of them are pretty fucking awesome, just saying. Alright, so anyway, there's a house here. Let's check this out. Ahoy, ahoy, anyone gonna freaking attack me? Penta's house discovered. Penta? Like pentagram? What does it mean? Seriously, though, I need someone to sell my shit. Oh, there's a chest here. See my chest? Can I? Nope, can't take it. Okay. Fine! Be like that, I didn't want you anyway! Can I use it? Nope. Okay, so blueprint, firm, a leather armor, handicraft, 20. See, 20 handicraft! Good god! Good god. It's gotta be a tool, right? The hammer? Fuck it, we'll take them all. Use wood block. Okay, so we can get some wood. You need a woodcutter's axe. I have an axe, or a hatchet. Is that not good enough? And I guess not. Do I need to equip it? Let's give it a try, just in case. Oh, come on, man. I want to sing the Chopping Wood song. Chopping wood, chopping wood, chopping as we go. We need a key for that as well. So I wonder if it's hidden around here somewhere. Like, you know, under the flower pot or something. Or maybe we're just not supposed to come here yet. If I were going to hide a key right outside a house, where would I do it? Actually, I don't see anywhere there could really be a key hidden. Yeah, okay, I guess we need to come back to this. Alright, so I suppose we will head for that house over there, straight ahead. The castle, whatever it is, just because it looks interesting. I don't suppose we can use these boats, can we? Don't know anything. Barrel's empty, bunch of fishing rods that seem to serve no purpose. Okay. Don't know what's in the water, could be more of the slaughter fish thingies. Could be nothing, could be much worse things. It's a little terrifying, that looks kind of strange. Anyway, what was that? Oh, just a bunch of seaweed. See, it wouldn't surprise me if there's things hidden under the water, like shipwrecks and what have you, that maybe aren't even marked off on the map. They have booty, you see what I mean? Stuff like this. They seem to have crammed a lot of rewards in for searching around, for exploring, which I like. I'm a big fan of that. I just realized we have jack shit lockpicks. Like, absolutely jack shit. That's not good. We need to find a town, man. New lockpicks. Does it mean I haven't done one of that level or something? It might. You are most definitely alive. You seem to be one of the big fellas. Yep. Yeah. Get dunked on, sir. Get dunked on. Man, you got freaking owned. You didn't even hit me. You suck. I'm trying to keep an eye out so, you know, nothing pops up to ambush us. Okay, so we've been there. Man, that place is further away than it looks. Seems like, markers on the compass show up from quite a ways away. Where have I been going? 30 minutes already! Bloody hell! Time doth fly, does it not? Yes, I used oldie timey English. Suck it. There'll be something else to annoy people with. Ha ha! Get dunked on. You know what? You deserve a teabag for that as well. Yoink! See, this is what I would do if I was an adventurer. I'd just be teabagging the shit out of everything I kill. But let's be honest, if I was an adventurer, I'd probably be dead in 5 minutes. So, this is why we play video games. I don't get to teabag people enough, you know? Ore terminal discovered. What the hell does... Ah! Oh, why? That was me saving. Well, whilst you were busy talking shit, I freaking basically killed you. You suck. You really suck. Maybe you never learn, huh? Maybe you never... You know what? You know what? Hang on a second, buddy. Hang on a second. I know some people go, this is breaking my immersion. You're doing things in the middle of combat. Shut up. Deal with it. Ha-ha! I blocked it. I'm the greatest. Come at me, broski. Fucking what now? Exactly. You got dunked as well. Warhammer? Nah, it's too heavy, man. What the? I think I organized it. You know what? Oh, she's stuck in the ground. Oh, that sucks. Oh, I think, yeah, they're like attached to their weapons or something. Yeah, some weird thing like that where they seem to be attached to their weapons. Is someone shooting me? I thought my HP just went down for no reason. I guess it didn't. You're right. Lanterns. Ooh, it's a skeleton. Hey, bud, how you doing? One penny? One freaking penny? Oh, hello. Prentice book mentalism. Okay, so we can raise our mentalism with that. We really should go use the skill points. Hey, you know what? Let's do that now. Let's do that now before I forget. Boop. If I forget to cut out this load screen, I do apologize. Because, yeah, I probably will. Alright, there you go. I talked over it. Works. Okay, so. Here we go. Sure, let's keep going. Apprentice of the Dark Arts. I guess we have to get... Do we have to get this one? Yeah, we have to get this one. The memories of the Sinister Orb teach you to use your... sonic spells stay 15% longer in effect. And triple spells consume 20% less health. Sure, whatever. Oh! So now we can get this. Reducing the mana cost of sonic and entropy spells of the apprentice and novice level 30%. And then, now we have some options. We can get mystical binding. Bound weapons do 40%. I mean, I don't even have a bound weapon. What's this? Allows you to cast a more powerful version of a sonic or entropy spell if you equip it in both hands. So dual casting for those types. And sonic spells now... can now be cast on enemies with a 35% higher level restriction. So... things like, you know, turn undead up to level 12, it will work for things that are 35% higher. I mean, that's something, I guess. Not exactly the most exciting thing in the world, but it's something. Can we just pick up a mentalism book? Because we're obviously going into the psionic tree. I can't remember if psionic and mentalism come under the same thing. I don't think they do. Really hope the game ain't crashing, because it don't look good, does it? Okay, we're back. Thought the game had crashed. Where is my weapon? Alright, it's back. So, let's open up the hero menu for a second here. What is all this? Okay, fever. Oh, okay, it's all that shit. Entropy, psionics, mentalism. What have we been putting skill points into? Spectral shields from your bare hands. Isn't it entropy? I think it's entropy that we've been mostly doing. We did just pick up a mentalism book, right? Let me double check. Probably here. Or not? Where would it be then? Hang on a minute. Where the bloody hell would it be? It's gotta be here, right? Oh, nope, that's not it. Dude, where the hell is this book? Give me a second here. Oh, okay, they apparently come under food. I mean, consumables, I guess. But, I mean, that's a picture of an apple, so whatever. So, since we don't know if we're going with block or light armor yet, I won't use those since, you know, they consume points that we have a limited amount of. Light magic. I mean, mentalism, light magic, fuck it. We'll use both of these, I guess, because we're going to be a mage. So, sure. Sure, we'll go with that. Alright, so we looted those fools. Is there anything else around here? Guy looks so pretty now, look at that maggot! I should rechange my hat. It's kind of a silly hat. I mean, it was funny at first, but now I just kind of hate this damn thing. Let me check over here. Yeah, there seems to be much going on. Alright, so like I said, we're gonna keep heading over to that. It looks like there might be a pathway around here. Actually... Oh wait, no, this is it! Okay, so that... Yeah, that has a different marker. Okay. I'm still gonna head over to that, because it looks too damn interesting not to. Quite frankly. Oh, hello. Thou art my light, my glimmer at the horizon. Thy name is my sacrament, and thy path I will honor in life as in death. The path of the sea. Right. Ooh, a leather hat. Right as I said I was gonna change my helmet. This works. Let's drop one of the iron helmets that we're carrying, and then we'll put on the leather helmet. I mean, it still looks a bit shit, let's be honest. But it doesn't look half as shit as what we were wearing. We were wearing a pot on our head, you know? We looked like one of the kids from South Park. And, you know, the South Park video game. Oh, hello. Yeah, I mean... Yeah, we just don't have the space, do we? It's not even... It's just not even that valuable. See, I would imagine stuff like that probably is randomly generated. I think if I remember correctly. Because I used to mess around with the creation kit quite a bit. We should check out that whilst we're there. Oh, hello, skeleton. I think if I remember correctly, the way you could do it is that you can, essentially... Who's hitting me? Oh, son of a bitch. I think you can essentially program it so that... For example, in that chest, we could have... If we were doing it, we could have placed down, you know, let's say a steel sword that's always there, and then have a randomly generated potion and a randomly generated, like, I don't know, fucking... Why is my brain blanking? I don't know, a potion and a piece of food or something. So, it might be set up that that chest, for example, is set to... I'm sure a lot of people don't give a shit about this, but I'm gonna tell you anyway. It might be set up that that chest is set to have two pieces of random clutter in it or something like that. So there you go. Alright, I'm gonna shut up about that now, because I'm even boring myself, which is quite an achievement. Quite an achievement indeed. Yes, I know we took a lot of damage there. Look, we have Moon Carrot. We're fine. Oh, good lord, we're not fine. We are not fine. Alright, you know what? Nope. 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 Equip the other hand. What are you doing, man? What the? Why's my other hand dumping out? Oh god, everything broke. Don't freeze. Oh my Christ. What is going on with this right now? Please just die, sir. Okie dokie. Do you have anything good? No. Oh my god, really? We need a merchant. Like, really bad. You know, get rid of all the iron swords. They're all crap. They're all crap. I want these ingredients, because, I mean, for all I know, alchemy could be really important. And I would imagine it's probably pretty similar, if not exactly the same as it is in Skyrim. And it was pretty easy to use in Skyrim, because you just, you know, combine different things, and then eventually it would be like, you need, you know, a butterfly wing and a moth wing, and you can make a restore health potion. Read letter. Sure. Dunwar. Or Dunwar. Dunwar. I appreciate your concern, but like always, I think that you are worrying too much. Grandmaster Aramthiel himself approved the mission, and don't forget the two keepers of the second signet are accompanying us. Besides, this is a good opportunity to impress the masters. Lambert, the only novice who was willing to accompany the infamous cranky master Bisara, alias the Broom, to an expedition. Hearing it like that, you forget that we merely have to dust off some Pyrian urns at the Sun Coast. Anyway, how are you? I'm betting you are thinking of nothing else but the examination. What a shame that Batar really allowed this devil woman instead of Clara. But well, we all know that his path abiding is limited to the daily walk to the liquor merchants. I'm with you in my thoughts. If you can't pass this examination, who else? Your friend Lambert. Ryan. I don't know what the hell Christopher Lambert's talking about there. That was confusing as hell to me. The Path Tome 12, The Star Summer Night. Sure. Not gonna read it. I'm guessing this is gonna be quite long, and it just seems to be some kind of a lore thing, so there you go. I'll go through the pages. We'll take the book, because it might have some kind of inherent value. I don't know. Man, I got jumps. Oh, hello. Oh, it's a carrot. Look at the way it's glowing. I thought it was really important. It's just a bloody carrot. I mean, I'm taking it. Heater Old Sherath. Potion of Woe. Do I want that potion? It's got decent value. Alright, another light armor book. I really like what they've done so far with their, you know, the loot. And put it this way. Exploring randomly feels much more rewarding in this than it does in Skyrim. Which is, you know, that's an achievement. They've done really well so far. The rest of the games like this, I'm down with it, man. Plane. It weighs two bloody hell. No wonder we're so over-encumbered. I'll just sleep for 1 hour. It should restore HP. Yeah, okay. Good, good, good. Kind of fit through there? Oh, never mind. It's a window. I was thinking it was a door. See, back in Yero's house, there's still that trap door that we don't have the key to. There's like so many things. For all I know, Alfred, for example, might be like, yo, I was friends with Yero. You can have his key. I doubt it, but you never know. What's up with this gate? Expert. Oh. That'll be what the key's for, then. I realize we're really detouring from where we should be. And I probably should stop. Let's just check out this last little bit down here. Evening, gents. How are you? Good. Good to know. I missed. Stop moving! I'm trying to do a little sidey swap. Let me do a side swap. Ah, you dick. Now I got no stamina, so I can't do it. Oh, you suck. Dude, how cool does this look? Look at this shit, man. And apparently this was behind a locked gate. So I wonder if this is the only entrance to this section. I'm also wondering if it's going to be full of enemies, considering there were two skeletons guarding the doorway. We're gonna find out whatever that is, because we're right next to it. Hello? I hear more skeletons, I think. I swear I heard the clanking of bones. Did I run into a corpse or something? No. Okay, so it's a ruin. Cool. Yep. Ah, looks like we might not be able to go in it. But maybe we can. Let's deal with these guys first. Get out of here. I know we got time for your bullshit. Okay. You know what? I'm not even gonna examine your body. You disgust me. Alright, more moon carrot. Yep, okay, so it totally is a ruin that we can go in. which I feel like we shouldn't do yet. So let's try and head over to Alfred, mostly because we just don't have space. I really just want to find that town where Alfred is, because I think they said he was in a town like River Run or Riverville or Vale or something. So we're going to head over there. And then we're going to hope that... wait, what is this? Oh, that's right, we can go back to Jesper now. See, here's the thing. If you can hear me clicking, there's no fast travel. Which really sucks. Really sucks. So for example, if we want to go back and speak to Jesper, which you can't do, we have to walk all the way there. For a let's play, that ain't exactly ideal. I'm going to see after this episode, and you know, hopefully once I get the sounds fixed, if there's a mod to put the fast travel back in, just for areas that I found, because, you know, immersion and all that shit's great, I'm sure. But here's the thing. Let people choose, you know? I don't see the reason not to give people fast travel if they want it. And then the people that want to go for the whole immersion, I want to walk everywhere stuff, can do that. You know, you don't have to use fast travel. Summon sword, that could be very handy. Chain lightning and circle of protection. Alright, we found some good stuff there. Some good stuff. Some good shit. Alright, let's check this out. So what's circle of protection do? I think that was in Skyrim, I just don't remember what it does. Lost ones up to level 6 flee. Okay, so low level skeletons will run away. Is that handy? I don't know. Lion bolt does 18 points of shock damage. So it's more powerful and it probably chains. And summon sword. Magical sword at level 5. Let's use that right now actually and see if it's more powerful than what we're using. It probably is. 23 per second? Is that what it's saying? Is that the way it actually works? Oh, that's right, it's going to be in that hand. Oh, that's annoying. Can I even see what my summoned weapon does in terms of damage? I think you could do that in some of the games, apparently not in Skyrim. Hmm. You can definitely do that in Oblivion, like summoned armor and stuff. You can go into your menu and see equipped on you and see like what its stats are. Doesn't look like that's the case here. That's kind of shitty. Alright, let's put it in the right hand. And I guess we can dual wield. I don't know what it means by, like, 23 per second. Is it going down? Maybe me... It doesn't seem to be going down. I do not exactly understand. Did that get rid of them? Yes, that's what I thought. Okay. Anyway. So where do we come in so I can bloody leave? I think it was maybe over there? Let's go have a look-see. Actually... Was it over here? Dude, I have no idea where I came in now. God damn it. So we've been going like 50 minutes already. Oh, this was not it. This was not it at all. May as well give it a try, right? Okay, it did work. It just took forever. Ha ha! Yep, that seems reasonable. Ooh, it's actually making sound effects. I forgot what they sound like. Dunked! Alright, like it. Like it a lot. Not gonna loot them. And I'm out of town for that shit. Is it like a beehive or something? Alright, well anyway, this is not where we came in. The map, I don't know if it's gonna be that helpful. Because if I were just quick travel, this would... God damn it. God damn it, it's so annoying. You couldn't quick travel in Nehrim either, I did mention that. I don't agree with it, man, I really don't. I don't like when modders do that stuff. It's almost like, the whole not having quest markers. We do have quest markers, but, you know... There are some quest mods where you won't have that. That's another thing I don't really agree with. Like, for example, if I don't mark this, boom, no more quest markers. But if I want the quest markers, here they are. So, again, it's one of those things where, why not just give people the option, you know? If people don't want to use the quest markers, they don't have to mark it as an active quest, and then they don't have them. But when you don't give them quest markers even when they do have it marked, that's when I'm like, hey, now you're just being, like, kind of petty. Like, I don't get that. Like, I understand that... What the hell? I understand that you want... it. Like, it's your game, essentially. Your mod. Your whatever. But, you know, like, that's... Again, it's more like an inconvenience thing. Especially with the... Well, it kind of applies to both, but... Especially with the quick traveling. It's just super inconvenient not being able to, What the hell? I just realized that... I can't interact with that. And it's kind of glowing. That's freaky looking. It's just really convenient, you know, especially for someone who has limited time to record like I do. I don't have that much to record. I have a job, I have friends I have to spend time with. When I might have like an hour or an hour and a half or something, I don't want to spend 45 minutes of that hour and a half running back and forth, which is footage that I'm literally going to cut out because it's just me running back through an area you've already seen and I don't really have anything to say, and even if I did have something to say, it's footage, it just really isn't necessary. So it's one of those things that really bugs me. Like, I'm going to shut up about it now, but yeah, I'm totally going to look for a mod to reinstate the quick travel. I think it's a really basic thing. It's more like they've I think it's kind of like a checkbox. What is that noise? The hell was that? I think it's kind of like a checkbox, and if you uncheck it, then it disallows fast travel, so I could probably fix it myself, put it that way. But yeah. Right, it's been a while since I used the creation kit, and we already don't have certain sound effects, so I don't want to break it any further than it already is. So, okay, we can get rid of that custom marker. I guess I'll put it over there. Move. That'll give us at least the general direction that we're going in, even though we already have another marker, but sometimes those ones can be, hello. Less accurate than I would like. Guess we could use that right now. So this is back in Yero's house, isn't it? And we still haven't found the key to the cellar. Again, it might be that we get that from Alfred or something like that. Or I could simply be in his house and I've missed it. Oh, man. Alright, I'm gonna take another real quick look around here. I might cut it out. It depends if I find what I'm looking for, but I feel like we might have missed the key, so I'm just gonna try and be a little bit more thorough. And like I say, I'll probably cut it out. Unless I find it straight away. Alright, what up? I'm back. So yeah, I checked around the inside of the house and all around the outside. I can't find the key. That doesn't mean it's not there. It might just be under my nose and I might be missing it, but I really don't think I am. So apparently we've already been to Penta's house over there, so yes, I'll leave it. Man, we got some traveling to do. I would like to make it there before I end the episode. I might try and do that, but that means we're going to go over the hour marker, which I know there are a lot of people that like the long episodes. But to me, an hour is already long, you know? You gotta be bloody reasonable, so I try not to go over an hour. That seems to be more bandits. May as well kill them, I suppose. What up? Boop. It's clobbering time! Let's get the archer first. Ha-ha! Stick a move, bitch! Really, there are dwarves? Oh my lord. Okay, yeah, help me, yeah!
You'll pay for that,
Gavner! Oh, wait. Summon Ghostly Wolf. Go, my pretty! Dunked. Yeah, wolf buddy. Wolf on wolf violence. What would Dr. King say? He'd say, kick his ass, sea bass. Hey, baby. How you doing? Oh, I can't move her. Alright, what do you got? Money. Alright, keep the rest of that crap. Actually, nope, never mind. It's just another leather shield. There's a rest here. Boop. Sierra Hotel, India, Echo Lima Delta, Shield. Ba-nam, 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 bum-bum, ba-nam, 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 bum-bum-bum-bum, boo! We already have that blueprint. Boo! Boo! Oh man, I can see why some people hate me. I think I'm a fucking delent. Like, an absolute delent. I'm like Marmite, though, you know? I can get why I would be one or the other. Let's go check out this house over here as well, just because, you know, it could be a settlement where there's a dude selling stuff. More specifically, buying stuff. There's a chest over here. I can't remember. You important? Kind of, yes, because we don't have a leather chest piece. What are we wearing on our chest? A vagrant dress. It's got 12 armor. What does the leather chest piece have? Where the bloody hell is it? I actually have my thing on it. It's better. Sure, we'll go with that. And we'll drop our vagrant dress. Yeah, we'll go with that, yeah. Oh, look at us now, Ma. Are you proud of me, Ma? Yeah, you are. Alright. Oh, it's locked. Oh, come on! Low on lockpicks. Give a brother a break, man. Oh, God. Okay. And we get a health potion. Well, I mean, you know, it's something. That ain't much, but it's something. That's what I mean. So, for example, like in that chest, they might have set it to just be like, give random potion. And, you know, you don't know what you're gonna get. Wait, isn't this the dog? The wolf? Yes. Sure, we'll go with it. We're summoning ghostly things. I think I just smacked my wolf. I'm sorry, buddy. Oh, God. Hit me. Sorry, I keep hitting you, I think. Oh, my God. Get out of here. You stop walking in the way, man. I'm like a lion when it eats. You can't get in front of it. Otherwise, you know, it's dangerous. I hear skeletons. Which means there's no one fucking alive here. Is everyone just dead in this land? Or, you know, a highwayman? Fuck you. You sniper son of a bitch. Give me those freaking arrows. What are you finding? Buddy? Sounds like he mauled another skeleton. You know what? He's probably about to despawn, so we'll just re-summon him so he can protect us. What do we get? Lube oil? Man, I missed that name the first time around. That's sexy as hell. Need some lube oil in this land when we find a nice lady. You can't just go in dry, you know? Increases your mana by 12 points. Sounds handy for us, because we're a mana person. Increases your stamina by 10 points. We already have the exact same ring, I think. Let's organize it by name. Yeah. So aren't we wearing, yeah, the badge of the apothecary, which doesn't seem to do anything. It's cool looking. Doesn't seem to do anything, though. So, where's my, yeah, here we go. Perfect. Perfect. I keep opening the frickin' the console. That's a shield. We don't need it. What the? Oh, there you are. Wonder what I was bumping into. Well, that's disappointing. Again, like, every time I'm like, oh, it could be a town. Nope. Ain't a freaking town, man. I mean, there are definitely towns and settlements and things like that, because, you know, on the load screens, we've seen tips that, like, you know, most shops open at 8 a.m. and close at 8 p.m. I'm like, oh, cool. Also, I don't know what's going on with this summoned sword, but it doesn't seem to be really costing anything. What the hell? I think I just beat the shit out of my dog again. Yeah. We make a great team when you don't walk in the way. Hint, hint. Yeah, get him. Get him! Get him! Yeah! Holy crap, I'm dying. What up, butterflies? I noticed that in regular Skyrim as well, the butterflies tend to congregate on the same flower, so you just get clusters of the bloody things. I'm very tempted to just use a healing, so you know, fuck it, fuck arcane fever. That's not what I was looking for. Did I? Is it Boone? Is Boone it? Here we go. What the? Yeah! Your arcane fever worsen. This negative affects your character values. Son of a bitch. Guess we'll use some of the ambrosia then, shall we? Alright, so what I'm learning is you don't really want to use healing spells unless you're in combat, and you really need to. Which frankly sucks. Old tunnel discovered. I mean, yeah, it's a descriptive name. I'll take those. Ah, oh, come on, man. Oh, God, I hate having to... This is why we need a town. I wanna get rid of some of the stuff. Yeah, these... Yeah, they're crap. We'll get rid of those. Can I drop down there, I wonder? I wonder if I can. I wonder if that will, like, throw me into a dungeon. Oh, actually, we're probably supposed to go down there. Doesn't mean I'm not gonna try, though. Doesn't mean I'm not gonna try. Get out the goddamn way. Can I break this? Ah, lame. Oh, was that a strong box? Nope. Ah, it was sitting like that, and the little bump on top of that looked like a strong box was sitting right there. Or, you know, maybe I'm really, really blind. Though I am wearing glasses now. So, I could be blinder. Alright, let's go in the tunnel. We're here. We're queer. We don't want any more bears, etc., etc. I'm not actually queer. It's a very old school Simpsons reference. Holy shit. This looks very cool. Hello, how are you? Fucking dead, I thought so! Boom, son! That's right, I'm using my crappy crap. Hold on. Hold the phone, buddy. Hold the phone. Alright, get that out. No, stop it. Go, wolf buddy, do my bidding! And then, get a mystical sword of mysticalness. No. Other hand. And get flame in the hand, and we summon our mystical sword. And then we steal the kill! No! Ah! You dick. Couldn't even steal the kill. Slatter does nothing. Okay. By the way, just at first glance, really cool looking area. Again, I haven't seen a dungeon, whatever you want to call this, that looks like this in Skyrim. Spelltome Divine Shield. Is that like an ethereal shield or is it something else? I am in the wrong menu because we have to learn it first, don't we? So it's here, Spelltome Divine Shield. Increases armor rating by 80 points. Dude, that seems like a lot. 240 seconds as well. Like for example, our Curious gives us 19. That's over quadruple what our Curious gives us. That's a lot, man. I mean, obviously we're wearing other stuff, but still, the Curious is going to give you the biggest part because it's a chest piece. A little scared about what we're going to run into here. You scared the crap out of me. Don't do that. There's a dead skeleton there. Hello? Maybe we'll finish up this dungeon, or at least, depending on how big it is, there's a troll there or something like that. We'll check out this dungeon. Depending on how big it is, we may finish it. And then end the episode after that. We'll see. Aha! Clobbered. Freaking clobbered. Give me your fat. Wish we had a light spell. I don't know what that blue thing is. It's probably some of those crystals that up your arcane fever, actually. Another one of these puddles of ectoplasm. It doesn't, like, I'm not killing a ghost or anything like that, and I can't loot it. So, I feel like they have some kind of significance that I just don't understand, maybe? Have I been up here? No, I don't think so. Where did I come in? Whoa! Holy crap! What are you doing there, buddy? What are you doing there? Oh my god, I thought he was killing me for a second there. Alright, yeah, we're getting a little low on the HP. You know, give me a fat. I mean, that answers that question. We haven't been up to this section yet. More shrooms. Coal, iron, sure. God, I need space. I need a fender, man! Oh! The sword unsummoned itself. That's a lot of blood. A lot of bones as well. Shit! Dude, that actually scared the crap out of me. I'm gonna take a potion. Just the one, because we have a lot of them. And, you know, arcane fever, which is really irritating. And then, dunk him down there. There you go. That's right, we have chain lightning. Did I use that spell tome yet? I guess so. Alright, so chain lightning. Then leaps to a new target. Don't leap to my wolf dude. Idiot! Dude, he just mauled the hell out of it. That is not okay. That is not okay. Come back here. This is one of those things I was complaining about. Just with the combat system in Skyrim. So, like, I can't jump because I have the spell prepared. If I could, I could have got back up there and got him before he, you know, came all the way around. Kind of irritating. Kind of irritating, Skyrim. Can we get a new kill animation, please? I mean, like, the same one three freaking times in a row. I mean, it's cool and everything. Oh, there you are. So, you're not dead. You just suck. Good to know. Good to know. I wonder if it's going to be more than just him in here. Like, all this blood? Two silver rings on a goat. Why do you have silver rings? What the hell? Okay, another pair of boots from a set. And a cool-looking backwards chest. Doesn't bother me at all, I swear. You know what? We'll take all those for now. Okay, we're not recumbent. Good, 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 good. Yeah, I got a feeling this isn't going to be a huge dungeon. It seems like it's just this one section. But it could be wrong. Let's check over here. Is there something under here? Nope. Yeah, it depends what's going on, like, past that blue crystally thing in the distance. Can I go around there? Nope. It doesn't look like we can platform up there, which I'm okay with, because you know platforming. Hello, buddy! How you doing? Boop! Alright, you know what? We need to favorite... Oh, guys, like, right on my face. We need to favorite Chain Lightning and Summon the Wolf and that. Alright. Okay, hang on. Someone go see Wolf. Put it down. And then get out Chain Lightning. B-E-A-utiful. Alright, come here, you son of a bitch. There you go. Man, that destroys my mana. Aha! Yeah! Freaking teamwork. I think I just accidentally used my level up on HP. Was gonna use it on mana, but it popped up right in my face. See, that's one thing they can improve. Because in regular Skyrim, they're like, you leveled up, press this button, and then you go in the, what is it, this menu that I'm not supposed to be able to access. You go here, and you do it here. So that avoids, you know, those accidents. So, they could fix that. Don't know if they will. Iron War Axe are gleaning. It's enchanted, so it's worth taking. I think I hear another troll, which could be a problem since we're over encumbered. We'll see. Ring of Precision. Okay, it could be good when we're actually using a bow, which I would like to, but I want to fix the sound effects first, because it sounds like shit. And we'll drop that for now. It weighs a lot. Alright. New lock picked. Okay, so it's not that that's a new level of lock, it's just a new lock. Alright. Seems like a weird thing to pop up on the screen. These are definitely going to increase my arcane fever, right? Yeah. But there is a booty over here. Potion protection for frost and something else. So it doesn't seem to increase your arcane fever that quickly. So it's not a huge concern. It's an interesting mechanic. A little annoying that it's pretty much from any kind of healing except using food. I mean, I get... I'm, like, really stuck, aren't I? Yep. I get where they were going with that. Like, they were, obviously, the idea was that they didn't want you just to be able to heal really easily in combat, but the food allows you to do it easily out of combat. I get that. I do. But, yeah, I don't know. It seems a little more just... more of a slight annoyance than anything. But, you know, I mean, like I say, I appreciate the fact that they've tried something different. Alright, so it looks like we're done in this dungeon. Let me open up the map, actually. Yeah, I don't see anywhere else to go. Alright, so, like I say, I think we will end this episode here. And then next time, we will carry on our adventure, and hopefully, finally arrive at the town, city, whatever, where Alfred's hanging out, and go meet with Bruce Wayne. Thank you for watching! Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, I always appreciate a like, and thank you for your overwhelming support so far in the series. I really do appreciate it. You guys are awesome. I genuinely mean that. Also, go check out my Morrowind series and the Oblivion series, specifically the second season of the Oblivion series, because I'm a little bit batshit insane in the first season. Well, it was recorded a long time ago. But anyway, go check those out if you like Elder Scrolls, and I've also done a lot of Skyrim mods. Anyway, like I say, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed it, I always appreciate a like, and I will see you next time for more Enderal. Goodbye!